I feel like the women competing at the next edition of Miss Supranational are so strong. The caliber of their contestants have become so amazing, and there are so many incredible women competing at the next edition of Miss Supranational. Now, we don't know when that is. It has been postponed indefinitely, but there are about 40 countries that have crowned their title holders. I looked into all of them and I came up with a list of 10 women who at the moment are my top 10 out of these women who have been crowned so far. Usually at Miss Supranational, there are about 70 to 74 countries taking part. Last year, I think there were 72. There are 10 women on my list here who I really think have a very good chance of becoming the next Miss Supranational. At number 10 on my list is Bolivia Liz Claros. She is 25 years old and she stands at 170 centimeters. She's an artist, and what I like about her is she seems very earthy, very down to earth, very easy to talk to. And I think that Miss Supranational, more than anything, are looking for someone that is just easy to work with and things like that. So I think that Liz Claros, she is a very beautiful woman, and I think that she stands a chance to, you know, get into the top 10. Next on my list, I have Peru, Camila Escribel. She is also 25 years old and stand at 177 centimeters tall. She is a professional model, and what is interesting about her is that in 2019, she reached the top 10 at Miss Grand International. Now, I don't really follow Miss Grand International, but it is a well-known pageant in the pageant community. It's just maybe not my taste. If you do well at one international pageant, you usually will do well at another international pageant. Next on my list is Czech Republic Angelina Kostyshyn. She is 24 years old and stands at 174 centimeters tall. She is currently a student. What I like about her as well is she does seem very down to earth and very kind and sweet. She does seem a bit shy, so we'll have to see what she does. I hope she receives the proper training in order for her to do her best at Miss Supranational. Next on my list is Canada, Sasha Lombardi. I don't really know much about her, only that she's well known in the pageant circles in Canada. So I hope the best for her. We'll have to see how she does, but I'm sure she'll do very well. Since she is Canadian, she's obviously very prolific in the English language, and I think she'll do fine. Next on my list is Puerto Rico, Carla Gilfu. Please excuse me if I botch surnames. She is a psychology student, and I think she's just gorgeous. She's obviously very photogenic, and I do think she has what it takes to reach the top 5. Even at the moment, she is my number 6, but if she works hard at it, and you know, she receives the proper training and things like that, I'm pretty sure that Carla has what it takes to reach the top 5. Moving into the top 5 now, at number 5 I have Panama Daray Santos. She is the tallest girl in my top 10 list at 186 centimeters. That is very tall. She is 26 years old and a model by profession. And what I love about her is that in 2017, she reached the top 15 at Miss International. Miss International is a very, very well-respected pageant, so I'm pretty sure that she will do absolutely amazing at Miss Supranational. At number 4, I have a Brazil, Deixa Benicio. She's 28 years old and stands at 177 centimeters tall. She is a law student, and what I love about her as well is that in 2014, she actually reached the top 10 at Miss International. Brazil may well come for the crown. She may well take it home, because in 2014, that was what, 6 years ago? Imagine how she has improved since then, since making the top 10 at one of the world's biggest pageants, as well as being a law student, which is very impressive. I'm sure she's a very intelligent woman, and I can't wait to see what she does on that stage. At number 3, I have a woman very close to my heart, Tatu Musele of my birth country, South Africa. 25 years old and stand at 172 centimeters tall. And she's a medical doctor, so she's obviously very intelligent. Other than that, she is absolutely gorgeous. She looks like a supermodel, and she is very, very, very funny. I love this woman to bits, and I can't wait to see what she and Werner and the rest of the Miss South Africa team achieves at Miss Supranational. At number two, I have Indonesia, Jihan Almira Chedid. Although she is only 20 years old, she has such a long list of achievements behind her. She's an absolutely incredible woman of substance. She is an actress and she's an ambassador for many charities. She stands at 173 centimeters tall, and for me, she is absolutely gorgeous. I can't wait to see what Indonesia brings at Miss Supranational at the next edition, because this woman has captivated me. Honestly, I'm obsessed. At number one on my list, honestly, how could I not, is my current home country, Namibia. Shanique Rawe is a 23-year-old fashion designer who studied fashion at FDISA in Cape Town. She's an absolutely incredible person, and she designs the most amazing gowns. In fact, the gown that she was wearing when she won Miss Supranational Namibia, she designed and created all by herself. In 2015, she competed against many other countries and states and won the title of Miss Teen Continent. She sadly hasn't competed at any other pageants since she was a teenager because she was studying at university. But I have absolutely no doubt that Shanique has what it takes to bring Namibia its very first Miss Supranational crown. That was my top 10 list for Miss Supranational 2020. Please let me know what you think down below in the comments. Do you agree with my top 5? I really would be fine with any one of these top 5 women winning, because they are all so amazing in my opinion. But other countries still have to crown their queens, so this list may change. Please let me know down below what you think, and like and subscribe. Also, follow me on Instagram because I post lots of pageant things over there, and I would love to see you. Thank you so much for watching. Bye!